hold on. Dad, just hang in there. Please be strong. After your operation, everything will be fine.
Sonia, have you seen Margaret?
No, ma'am.
Julian, tell me, how's your dad?
Mr. Emil's stable now. The operation was a success. He'll be okay.
Dad is in the ICU right now. He's still unconscious.
Mommy, I'm sorry for what I did. You know, my friend really needed me there.
Do this again, and I promise you, it will be the end of it.
Mr. Phil, you have a memo from our HR.
They're reprimanding me.
Oh.
Because of my absences.
I knew it.
Says here that they could terminate my contract.
Dad, please wake up soon. Dad, we miss you so much. Please come back to us, Dad. We love you so, so much.
Julian, Mackie,
hey,
is Dad awake already?
No, not yet. Pinong, do you think he heard me and Mackie talking?
Maybe.
He did. You made him laugh, because you were so dramatic.
Hey, you were the one crying and apologizing all day.
Oh, by the way, the doctor said he's going to talk to us later. It's about Dad's recovery. Where's Mom?
She went out for a bit. She talked to the doctor. Mm. Oh, by the way, we brought you a change of clothes, Pinong. Here.
Wow, how sweet of you.
Well, of course. We're always sweet, you just don't notice,
right? You should be sweet, guys, because we have many more hurdles to face.
But, you know, the worst is behind us already. So, whatever challenges may come our way, I'm sure we can face them all.
Could you please fix your hair so that when Dad wakes up, you still look good?
Fix it a bit.
It's so messy. Let's fix it like this. Let's style it a little bit.
Oh, Mrs. Chrysostomo. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Doc.
Ma'am, I called for you because I really wanted to talk to you about the post-operation of Mr. Emil.
When do you suppose will he wake up?
Doc?
Pinong told me it would
Good
take
morning,
two
Pinong.
To 3 days.
Well, it could take a little longer due to what happened during his operation. It may take longer for him to get well, but the good news is that the bleeding in his brain has already stopped now, and also his condition is stable. Ma'am, don't worry about your husband. We'll make sure to carefully observe Mr. Emil's recovery, but that will depend on the return of his strength and also the status of his vital signs. I think possibly after a week and a half, ma'am, the tubes that help his breathing can be taken off after that time, and he can be transferred to the ward.
Did you hear that, Mom? You'll be by Dad's side very soon.
But what can we expect? Will he become weaker than before? When does he get discharged? How long do we have to stay here until he recovers?
I'm afraid he's still very weak, ma'am, especially on the left side of his body. And he still can't move around on his own.
But, Doc, you don't think he's paralyzed, right?
Oh, no. He's just weak, of course. The part that controls all of our movements is our own brain. And when it's operated on, it can't be avoided that our movements will be affected.
Oh. So I guess it's like a car. You're going to have to jump-start it first, right?
That's right, Mackie.
Something like that. Well, based on our timeline here, probably after he has moved to the ward, well, after 2 weeks' time, Mr. Emil's rehabilitation can already begin. But this also depends on him, ma'am. Your husband has to be very committed to complete his rehabilitation. And with your help and support, after several months have passed, oh, he'll be back to normal.
Months, Doc?
Oh, Mr. Emil isn't allowed to work at all until he's fully recovered from this.
That's okay, Doc. He'll be better before we know it. Thank you, Doctor.
You're most welcome.
Getting ready for the post-op? You know, I spoke to Dr. Ardanza yesterday. He told me that Mr. Emil's okay despite all the complications during surgery. In fact, he's doing remarkably well. Is there anything wrong?
No, Doctor. I guess I have a lot on my mind. What Dr. Ardanza told me got me thinking earlier. I really need to focus on Dad's rehabilitation.
I understand. I expect nothing less from you.
But, Doc, I may no longer have time for other patients.
Wait, are you telling me...
I might have to leave the hospital to focus on my dad.
And give up on your dream?
If I really need to. I've always been the nurse in the family. I'm the one most capable of helping Dad recover faster than usual. And besides, you know, he's my VIP, very important patient.
I would honestly do the same for my dad, Peenum. But do you really have to choose over this? Why don't you just take a leave first? Nurse Malu and I will be the ones to explain to the hospital management.
Okay, Doc. I'm going to think about it.
Danica, revise this. This is not what I wanted you to do.
Yes, ma'am.
Just take it.
Sophia.
Hmm.
Can I talk to you for a second?
Are you finally going to apologize?
Yes, look. I'm really sorry about leaving work yesterday without telling you. It was an emergency. I really needed to be there.
Your girlfriend's dad?
He's like a father to me.
Phil?
I understand. But please understand that we need you here.
Yes, ma'am.
And I don't care about your personal life. All I care about is you getting the work done. I believe you're aware of how many projects we're handling, right?
That's why I asked Terrence and Leo to cover for me. After all, we're a team.
Wait, so you call the shots now? You're the boss.
No. I didn't mean it that way. Look, I'm really sorry for leaving without finishing all the work for the day. I will really try to do my best to work hard and catch up to the deadline.
Phil, let me give you a little advice. If you really want this job, you would set your priorities right.
Yes, ma'am. I know my priorities with work. And also, besides this job, it's also my loved ones, too. Excuse me, ma'am.
The doctor said that your dad can still hear us talking. But he just can't answer or move right now, though.
Dad? Dad, wake up already, please. It's noontime already. That was just a joke, Dad. It's way too quiet in here.
Love? This son of yours really takes after you, huh? He never runs out of jokes.
We're going to have our finals later, Dad. If I get a perfect score, will you finally wake up? Mom's here with me. She misses you so much.
And I know you really miss us too, love.
Don't worry about her, Dad. While you're resting and recovering, we're going to take care of Mom. And even if none of us ever inherited your great singing voice, I'll still sing to her.
At dahil mahal kita, sa'yo lamang liligaya, kahit katumbas nito'y kasawian. Dahil mahal kita, sa'yo lamang liligaya, at di na muling iibig pa.
Maki, Pina, where are Mom and Julian?
They're both inside.
Has Grandpa gone home?
Mm-hmm.
Mackie, Dad may have to stay longer in here. It's because of his rehabilitation.
Yes, I know. I was also thinking about it. I might also resign from my job.
Wait, I thought you'd ask for an advance from them.
I did, but I haven't gotten the check yet. They haven't given it to me. I was just thinking maybe I might make more money being a farm agent than being a mechanic. And besides, I still need to attend to the farm. I'm sure to get an earful from Dad if I don't focus on that.
We'll all need to talk about this, Mackie, because we have a lot of expenses now. And I know for a fact that this won't stop even after Dad is released. Of course, there's still his therapy, his maintenance, follow-up checkups. We need a lot of money for those. That's why we really need a game plan.
Oh, I'm game with that.
Am I included in that game plan you two are talking about?
Of course you are, Mom. I'm about to leave the house, babe. Let's just meet later after my class is finished, okay?
Oh, come here, sweetheart. Have some breakfast first. Your mom went outside to buy some bread. I cooked your favorite dish. It's sautéed sardines. Come on, let's have breakfast.
I'm really in a hurry.
By the way, sweetheart, your mom told me earlier about what happened to Mackie's father. How is he doing?
He's doing just fine. Okay, then. I'll be going now.
You take care, sweetheart.
Nurse Binang, you arrived here just in time. Mr. Emil's cabin is almost empty. We will need a new bag to change it in a little while.
Okay, nurse. Just give him whatever's needed.
Can you please have a look at this waiver, too? Because it's SOP when the medication is a bit expensive.
Dad might hear us talking about it. Even if he's asleep, his hearing is still very sharp.
Now I know why you're the favorite nurse in the ER. You're still positive despite any problem you're facing.
Well, you know what they say. Laughter is the best medicine in any problem. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, too. Bye.
Dad, I'm still smiling under this mask. I really hope you wake up soon so you can see us all, especially Mom. And we're all waiting for you. You'll wake up to see us all smiling.
Mommy, I'd just like to say sorry for what happened last night.
This won't happen again, Margaret.
I promise, Mom. It really won't happen again.
It really won't happen again. Because you're coming with me to Manila. And you'll be studying there.
But, Mommy...
My decision is final, and I know for a fact that that's for your own good. End of discussion.
If that's going to be your decision, then all right. I'm going to accept that. But can I please just make one more request? Can I just please stay here for the time being, only until Jillian's dad's condition becomes better? Please, Mommy. After that's done, I'll do whatever you want me to do.
All right. I'm giving you until the end of your semester break. And after that, you're coming back with me to Manila. Okay.
Binang, I'm just going to get the bill first, okay?
Oh, Mom, no, please. I'll just go get it later myself. Just stay here with Dad while I'm gone.
There they are.
Oh,
good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Uncle.
Oh.
Good morning, boys.
Hi.
Everything's all ready. We delivered the desserts. The receipts are all with Mr. Apple.
Oh, thank you so much, boys.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, how's Emil doing?
He's still the same, but the doctors are observing him now.
For now, there's nothing to worry about. He's doing okay.
I know Emil can still pull through. You know how he is. He's just like a bamboo stick.
And downloading, and, oh, bro, how did your meeting go? Did the boss get mad at you? Phil, I'm sorry for what happened earlier. I woke up on the wrong side of the bed. We're a team.
It's okay, Leo.
Okay, so you better make sure you keep your job so you can support them, okay?
I know. I made a promise to Mr. Emil that I would work really hard. Even when it's difficult. Even if Sophia scolds me.
Oh, man, you make me proud. Anyway, let's work.
Yes, back to work.
Yes.
So this is the working login page.
I know my priorities with work, and also besides this job, it's also my loved ones too.
There.
You have to do it right.
Pick here.
I'm very sorry, babe. We had to pass by the farm earlier. I had to check the water level in the rice paddies. Dad usually does that.
Mom and Dad are asking how he is doing, by the way.
Oh, he's fine. He's still in the ICU. But he's doing okay. He's still fighting.
I wonder, how do you do it, babe?
Do what?
That. You're smiling despite facing a difficult situation.
Well, I don't think I look good when I'm grouchy anyway, and I look better when I'm smiling and more handsome. Like this. Look. See? You fell in love with me more, huh?
You're just too kind to me. I feel pressured.
Wait, why? What do you mean, pressured?
I just want to be exactly like you. Like, how you love your family with all your heart. And how you love your father, too. It's really impressive.
Babe, why are you crying?
No, I got something in my eye.
Babe, you and your dad will work things out eventually, okay? It's just that some things can't be rushed, even if we want them to happen. We really have to be patient. Okay? Just relax. Everything is going to be fine, huh? As they always say, good things take time. Alright? It's okay. That's enough. Now don't cry anymore. Calm down.
Next, please.
Good morning, ma'am. May I please have Emilio Crisostomo's statement update from ICU number 2, ma'am?
Okay, just give me a moment. Here you go.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
All right, let's have a lunch break. Let's finish this up later.
Right.
Let's go.
I'll follow in a bit. I still have to finish this.
Huh? Why? You sure?
Yep, I have a deadline.
Phil, I'll just get you some takeout so you can eat. Your brain needs it.
Yes. How about me sometimes? I'll just text you what the choices are downstairs.
Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it.
All right, see you, buddy.
Miggy, where's Peanut? Is she with you?
Oh no, we're busy right now, but we'll visit them later. Why? Is there a problem?
That's it. I'm trying to call her, but she's not answering.
Maybe she put her phone on silent. Or maybe she's sleeping, since she's really tired.
Yes, that's my worry too.
Hey, can I ask
you and Nars a favor?
Sure thing, hold on. I'll just put you on loudspeaker so Nars can hear.
I'll go.
Okay.
When you two aren't busy, can you guys check on Peanut for me? Make sure she eats and rests.
You know how she is.
Yes, she's a workaholic. Always on the move and busy. But don't worry, Phil. If we have to kidnap her, we're going to do it. Yes, we will.
Thanks, guys. You guys are the best. Thank you.
Bye.
Sure thing. Bye, Phil.
So did I hear it right? You two need to have someone kidnapped. Actually, I know someone. If you need help with it, just say the name. I'll handle it.
She sounds serious, friend. I'm scared.
I'm waiting.
It's Peanut Nurse Malou.
Oh, Nurse Malou,
it's
come
just
on, really?
Wanted to kidnap.
What are you doing here? Go back to your rounds
yes, ma'am.
Now.
Okay, ma'am.
All right.
Bye.
Check on her, but after
okay.
the duty.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, ma'am.
I hope everything is going well there. Let me know when you need anything. Love you.
Mom?
Hello, Pinang. Did you get the updated bill already?
I did. But don't worry about it, Mom.
Discounts haven't been included in it yet.
The health insurance, senior citizens discount, I'll just bring the bill to you later on.
How much is it?
It's more than 600,000
now, Mom.
Is the doctor's fee included in it?
No, not yet.
Don't worry about it. I can still get a discount.
Okay then, dear.
Goodbye, Mom.
Oh, finally. The exams are over. Seriously, I really hope we get high grades, right? So my dad will be pleased with me. And your mom, too. By the way, it's good your mom allowed you to visit us at the hospital yesterday. Thanks again for that.
It's nothing.
What do you mean nothing? To me, it's everything, you know? I really appreciated it a lot. But, I'll make it up to you next semester. I can't right now. You know how it is. I'm a little broke. But, I promise, I'll make it up to you next semester.
Next semester? That's way too long. Why don't you make it up to me now? You don't have to treat me anyway. Even just hanging around here with you makes me happy.
Really?
Yes, it does, even if we just stare at each other the whole day.
The whole day? But no blinking, okay?
Wait a second. Don't move, okay? I said don't move.
Okay.
Just stay put. Hold on. Oh, your hair. I can't see your eyes because of it.
Better?
You can do this, Pinang. You can do this. We can do this.
Hey, Pinang!
What's with all this drama? You all right? You're talking to yourself now.
It's just one of two things, hunger or fatigue.
Mm-hmm.
I'm okay, guys.
Oh. And she's still denying it when it's so obvious she's not fine, see?
Nurse Malou is calling for you.
Did she say why?
I don't know. Just
whatever,
go to her.
Right?
Just come
on.
Already. She needs
yes,
you right
go.
Now. Come
hurry
on.
Up. She wants to know the shampoo you use.
Don't look at it yet.
Are you drawing my portrait?
No, it's just,
Is it done?
Yes.
Let me see. Something's missing here.
What?
Don't move an inch, okay?
What's that?
There. It's done. They should always be together, no matter what.
Where's Nurse Malou? She's not even in here.
Oh, what are you talking about? Wait. I'll go get her now. Here she is! There she is, look.
Nurse Binang, do you have any idea what a dehydrated and sleep-deprived patient looks like?
Take a look at a mirror and you will know what I mean.
You guys, someone might hear you and you'll get into trouble.
Oh, don't worry, friend. She knows about this.
Yes! She's really so kind. She actually allowed us to borrow her room so you can rest and regain your energy.
No, I need to go back to my mom right now.
Wait. No. Not until okay. You've taken a power nap, Pina.
There, go.
Come on.
Just sleep.
Go to sleep. Stay right there. Let the baby sleep there. She'll go to sleep
Come
now.
On.
Hurry.
Oh, baby.
Hurry up. No, take a picture. Take a picture.
We made a promise to Phil. Go on now. Go to sleep. Here's the evidence. There.
Yes, you see?
Time to go.
Wait!
No, stay right here.
That's right. Just go to sleep.
Go to sleep first.
You have
Are
to
you
rest.
Sure, guys?
Yes, girl. You're there anyway.
Just sleep.
Come okay, on, Binang.
We'll leave a bit.
Yes.
We'll go buy some food, okay? Stay here.
Okay, good night. Enjoy. Nurse Malou will look after you.
What do you think?
I sent you a copy of my deliverables for the body needer. Please let me know what you think. Thanks.
Just what we need.
Finally.
Are you done?
Are you guys hungry?
Yes, just in time, bro. I'm starving.
Yeah.
Okay, let's find something to eat.
All right.
Let's go. You texted her? Did you...
I just received your email. Are you guys leaving?
Dinner?
Do you want me to work on something?
Oh, no. I just ordered pizza for those who stayed overtime. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yes, of course.
Thank you, Sophia. We really appreciate it. It's so nice of you.
Okay, just wait for the pizza then.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. What? First time, ma'am? You are the man! You're the only one who made Sophia order pizza! You're awesome! You know, you're the man. Really.
Margaret, isn't your driver coming along?
I told Mom earlier I'd drop by the hospital to visit your dad. If that's okay with you.
Oh, really? It's fine by me, but you really don't have to do that.
Why shouldn't I? That's part of my best friend duties, right?
Wow, my best friend's so sweet today. But, hold on. You know, that's kind of strange of her. Your mom's not being strict with you today.
Don't you like it?
I do. But, it's just strange to me.
Anyway, let's go. Let's go to the hospital.
Come on.
Come on, hurry up. What time's it?
Is that how you usually wake up, Ina?
I wasn't able to talk to my mom.
We already did it for you. We told her we made you rest up.
Mm-hmm. And we brought you some food. Here you go.
So go on,
Thanks,
eat
guys,
up.
I really need to see my dad right now.
Hold on.
They really need me there.
Minutes. Why don't we just give this to Nurse Malou instead to say thanks? Besides, you're on a diet.
Today's my cheat day, girl.
Oh, that's
Might
how it is, huh? Cheat day, my foot!
Let's just
hey,
leave
watch
her
it.
Some.
Nurse Malou wouldn't want that.
Let's leave some for Nurse Malou. Or not.
You're looking so fat. How about liposuction?
Hey, you're so clean.
Hey, Marcy.
Oh, Andy, did you leave something behind?
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just meeting someone near the area, so I thought I'd visit Emil and see how he's doing.
Actually, the doctor told me Emil would recover much faster if his loved ones would keep visiting him very often. Thank you, Andy.
Oh, actually, Celia and I should really be the ones to thank you, Marcy. You know, you're such a good wife to my brother. We may be his siblings, but we barely even have time for our brother.
I'm sure he understands that. Of course, you have your own families to attend to. And you're also busy with your own jobs. You just don't realize how proud he is of you.
Marcy, Celia, and I want to help out with the expenses here in the hospital. I know Emil wouldn't like that, but let us make it up to you every now and then.
I'm sure he's very happy that you're here for him.
Mom?
Oh.
Uncle Andy?
Pinang. Oh. I'll go ahead.
Okay.
Remember what I said.
Thank you.
It's all right.
Are you all right, Mom?
Please call your siblings right this second. We need to talk.
Okay, Mom.
Mackie, I brought some hot soup for us. Pinang needs to eat, right?
Right, and you got Mom's favorite steam buns, did you?
I did, and you know, I bet they're starving. They haven't eaten yet. What about you, Margaret? What do you want?
Your mom's favorite's fine with me.
Oh, me?
Hey, who said it was you? I'm Mom's favorite, not you.
Fine, it's you then.
Julian, Mackie, Mom wants to talk to us right now.
Okay, okay.
Go on, Julian. My ride's here anyway. I'll go. Take care, Pinang.
Me too. Babe, I'll go ahead.
All right.
You guys
take care.
Bye, Margaret. Take care.
All right.
Thank you.
Let's leave together.
Okay.
Julian, let's go.
Pinang and I already have the current bill.
Mom, if you think that it's impossible for us to pay for this bill, do not. Because I've already come up with a solution. And here it is. It won't cover the whole bill, but I'm sure we'll be able to find a way.
Hey, this is good, Pinang. Add the tools in the vulcanizing shop to that. I get about a couple $100 if I
but
sell...
But Mackie, what will happen to your monthly income if you sell all that?
Well, I'm concentrating more on selling seedlings for the time being. The profit's much higher. Although it's not fixed income. And there's the, of course, the revenue from the last sale Dad and I made. We'll know how much commission we'll get by next week. Plus, there's also the revenue we will make from the harvest.
Pinang, wait. I can work too. It's our semestral break anyway.
If we concentrate more on the business, I really believe that we can pull this off. That's where we're going to get our biggest income anyway. And Mom, I also can take a leave to concentrate on the business and of course on Dad's recovery.
All right, but do remember, that's just the initial billing, dear. That'll still increase. Remember what they told us it might reach a huge amount of money?
Maybe we can still convince the hospital by giving them a promissory note. We'll be able to pay off the bill in small installments.
Oh, Mom, I'm still going to look for additional income too, okay?
Well, I have to say, kids, your ideas are all fantastic. But your dad did say to all of you, he doesn't want to see any of you guys having a hard time. I don't want that either. He doesn't want the family sinking deeper into even more debt. Now, I've also made a decision. We're going to do what your dad wants us to do. We're going to sell the farm.
Mom!
Hey, I don't like the idea, and I'm sure your dad doesn't want that as well. But your father and I both think this is the best solution we have now. And of course, you can't go against your father's wishes anyway. You know that. Let's respect it.
I just thought of the best thing to do right now. Let's go sell the farm. I just want to make sure of things. With all of our increasingly growing debts, we'll all have grown old, but we still haven't paid them all. Dignity is more important than wealth.
Pinang, you can't sleep either?
Pinang? Pinang, should we just do what Dad wants?
I know how much Dad loves this place.
Love, how are you feeling right now? You might be getting bored already. Please don't have any second thoughts about waking up, okay? We're all waiting for you to wake up. But I'm not pressuring you, dear. If you need more time to rest and recover, that's okay. Can you still remember what we discussed before? You know, regarding the farm? Let me tell you this, Andy and Celia, they want to help out with our hospital expenses. But I know you don't want to be a burden. And you don't want our children to be worried by it. So, whatever you told me before, I'm just going to stick with it, dear. Until the moment you wake up. Love? I really miss you so much.
He opened his eyes, but then he closed them again.
I'll inform the doctor, but don't worry about anything, ma'am. That's normal among patients who've undergone brain surgery. Excuse me, ma'am. I'll be right back, ma'am. I'll go call the doctor.
Thank you.
It's Mom. Hello, Mom? How's it going? Is there a problem with Dad?
Yeah, loudspeaker.
Mom, how's Dad doing?
Binung, your dad finally opened his eyes.
Mom, can we talk to him?
Mom, we're on our way there.
Oh, well, he closed them again, though.
But Mom, wake him up. We're on our way there in a bit.
But Binung, I was told that this is a good sign. Am I right about that?
Mom, yes, you're right. That's a really great sign, Mom.
Maggie. Let's go back to the hospital. Dad might wake up already.
Dad opened his eyes, Julian. That's different.
Whatever, Pina. As long as he can open his eyes, he can see how handsome I really am.
Okay, then. Just hurry up, all right?
We will, Mom.
Bye, Mom.
Bye, Mom.
Good morning, Biebs.
It's a beautiful morning. Dad opened his eyes.
We're here at the hospital now.
I'll be there in a bit, Biebs.
Huh? Wait, I thought that you had work today.
How will you come by?
Don't worry, Biebs. I'll make it. I want to be there.
Mr. Emil has responded remarkably well to the tests we gave earlier. But for the time being, he's drifting in and out of consciousness. It's only now that the anesthesia is wearing off and his strength is returning after the operation. In due time, ma'am, his complete consciousness will return. That's what we're waiting for.
Thank you so much, Doc.
Yes, Mr. Emil's a fighter.
He's not just any fighter, Doc. He's a real champion.
Okay, then.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you.
Good morning, guys.
Oh,
I brought some coffee for everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you, babes.
Oh, thank you.
Hold on, Phil. Aren't you going to be late for work?
Oh, not really. I came here early because Penang told me the good news. And I wanted to be here. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
A sweet smile this early in the morning, huh?
It's because Emil opened his eyes.
Wow, Mom Marcy, this is just in time. We're going to make the rice crops healthier. So when Sir Emil goes home, he'll be able to see them.
Is the weeding going to start tomorrow?
It's definitely a go. I told everyone. We'll be full force by tomorrow.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to prepare some snacks for tomorrow.
Oh, great. I bet it'll be bulalo.
Beebs, why didn't you tell them about the plan to sell the farm?
I can't help but think that if only I was able to get Dad transferred sooner, our bill wouldn't be so expensive and we won't have to sell the farm anymore.
Beebs, it's not your fault. You've done nothing but do your best, all for your family, right?
I was just thinking how sad Dad is going to be when he finds out that the farm will be sold soon.
Don't even think about it. Just do something about it. Fight for it. Right?
You're right. Now that Dad's opened his eyes, we can finally talk to him about it. And then we can bring up selling the farm to him again. That's perfect.
See? Things will work out, okay?
Thank you.
Please stop acting so sweet. You're giving our patients diabetes.
Dad opened his eyes.
And now's the perfect time for a group hug, us included. Oh, come on.
Mom, I can take care of things in the hospital. You should go home already because you haven't been able to get any sleep. You can't even rest here.
That's right, Mom. Later, Julian and I will be the ones to look after Dad.
Yes, Mom, we'll take care of Dad. It's fine, we promise.
I just need maybe a little nap, just a little rest, and I'll be okay again. Thanks, kids.
Go on, Mom. Sleep for as long as it takes for you to be recharged.
What am I, a cell phone?
Oh no, Mom. You're a flashlight. You keep shining light no matter how dark it gets.
You just want something, don't you, huh?
No, I don't, Mom.
Hey, Binang.
It's nothing, Mom. Go get some rest.
Thank you so much, really, all of you. I can't believe you brought home a lot of fruits.
Oh,
this is
right.
Good.
Wow, oh,
thank you.
Yes, he caught that just
in time. Really?
It's Marcy.
Oh, look, it's Marcy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mrs. Marcy.
Good morning, everyone. But isn't the harvest going to start tomorrow?
That's right, it'll start tomorrow. But we just heard from Badong today that Mr. Emil finally woke up.
So all of us decided to bring some fruits and vegetables just for him. That'll help him speed up his recovery.
Thank you so much, guys.
So how is he doing? When will he be discharged?
I hope he gets out in time for the harvest.
Well, yes, that's enough for now, okay? Let's just give Marcy a chance to rest. Why don't you have a seat and,
okay,
and prepare some coffee? Come on, let's go.
Need some coffee.
Come on, let's go.
Go on, Marcy. Go and get some rest first. You haven't been sleeping well. Go on, let me take care of things here.
Again, thank you very much to all of you. But I really have to go get some rest. I'll leave you guys to
okay,
it,
okay? Thank you so much.
You take care, okay?
Come on, pass
okay,
them up.
Let's go.
They need to get these fruits right away.
I have to sleep.
we'll be able to convince Dad not to sell the farm very soon.
It'll be easier for us to convince Dad not to sell the farm if we can show him we can afford to pay the hospital bill without much trouble.
But Pinang, it's too high. We can't afford to pay, especially if we have to shell out money that fast.
I think we can manage it if we pay it in installments. If we manage to give a down payment soon, we can pay the rest bit by bit. Besides, what's important is for Dad to see that even if the hospital bill increases by the day along with our farm bills, well, we can still come up with the money to pay everything off.
But then, Pinang, Dad doesn't want that.
Well, that doesn't really mean we'll go against his wishes. We'll try to make an appeal, but Dad is still the judge.
Okay. Attorney Mackey and Pinang, I'll leave it up to you. Let me look after Dad in the meantime.
Let's collect any payments we can get.
And then we can look for other means to earn more money afterwards.
Right. Go team. For the farm.
For our dad.
Game!